What's up? This is again your Dr. Hari Teja. So we have done with the part one. I'll just recall what it has happened till so far. We have seen what is the Indo-US relationship, and from the first slide we came to know that there is an ups and downs relationship. Why there is an up and down relationship, that has been explained, and what made the Indians to have a perception change in their minds, that we simply call it as a changed perception. And at the same time, from 1991 onwards, the newly infant baby which born from 1947 up till to 1991, we turned into a liberalization path, LPG policy, that made us to have a different kind of foreign policy towards international markets. This is the second slide that we have did, and the next one we have did what made to have a changed perception toward the international politics. 1991 is important for two things. One, for the dissolution of USSR. Second thing, it is very important for the India's LPG policy, liberalization, privatization, globalization, right? So due to the dissolution of USSR, we need to have our own foreign policy, not depending upon with any other country. That doesn't mean that we have depended before. You got my point, right? And the second point in the changed perception is that already International Monetary Fund was being described that the 21st century was being termed as an Asian century. So because most number of Asian tiger crisis which came into picture. So you can able to find out when there is a crisis, that mean to say they had a huge amount that they had in their pockets. You got my point, right? A beggar can't have a crisis. A rich person will have now you can able to find out from the news that Vijay Mallya was in crisis. That mean to say that once upon a time he is very a wealthy person, the same kind of aspect. So the fourth, the fifth, the sixth, the seventh bullet points you can able to find out in the slide number four that we have described and discussed already yesterday, I mean the previous class. Now the next one is all about Indian government is exerting some kind of pressure or some kind of activity in Indian Oceanic region. That also we have done with the slide recap of what I have told the previous part. And we are a founding father of the so many activities like Uruguay round, Doha round, 23 WTO. Now we are turning to be a growing economy. Due to India created some kind of wonders from 1991 onwards, due to these kind of activities, that India need to change their perception towards the international politics. But the interesting thing, we are talking about India-US relationship. So what made USA to turn to India? You can able to understand that India is angry on USA on some issues. USA had angry on India for some issues. We will see that those things also. But USA is something like their economy, you can say it is a capitalism. Capital mean to say money is a group of people having same ideas or same idols. So money minded people having same group idea, or a group of people having a money minded orientation. So whenever capitalism mean to say, whenever there is a profit making, there the capitalist used to come. So it is as simple as that. USA always try to make their profit venture in any other part of the world. Now there is a war between two countries, between USSR and USA, which you call it as a Cold War, right? And that Cold War was ended in 1991 after the dissolution of this thing. Before that Cold War, to counter the balance program or the power balance in Asian region, USA used Pakistan and Afghanistan very better way, and in turn Pakistan got huge profit two times from USA. From 1991, when USA got dissoluted or dissolved, that time onwards Pakistan is not able to get anything out of it. when two persons are under a relationship, it's as simple as that. If you and me are in a relationship, what will happen? I mean, don't, if ladies are, please excuse me. So, if two persons X and Y are in a relationship, suppose I used to give each and everything to the Y person, suddenly I stopped each and everything, not giving anything to the Y, automatically Y becomes an angry on X. It is as simple as that. So the same way, when Pakistan is expecting something out of the friendship of USA, but Pakistan is not able to get because USA use is over of Pakistan. When use is over, as a capitalist mind, what they will do? They will say bye bye and they went off. When they went off, Pakistan is getting some kind of friend from US, they got irritated. So Osama bin Laden is the one key factor. He went against to USA and he was the key person I think you come across. So Pakistan was some kind of a nation which don't have money. To counter the balance, USA used Pakistan, but India and China are very growing economy and China won't have a friendship with USA. So the only way to come to is nothing but India. So that is the reason he used to come to have a word with India. But why India is angry on US? On what matters? The mighty nation when it got independence in 1947 and the same mighty nation which got republic in 1950, from that day onward this mighty nation is struggling for feeding its own citizens. We do have a food crisis in 1951. Due to that food crisis, we approached USA for food aid, but USA cancelled it under two things. One is called PL 480. You can have a look. PL 480 here. I can highlight this thing. Highlighter. You can PL 480, and at the same time, it has been cancelled in another thing. Other thing part also, which is nothing but Vietnam War. Under Vietnam War, we are with the Vietnam. USA and Vietnam are fighting each other. At that point of time, we are with Vietnam and we are asking the against country for food aid. Obviously they won't give us, but they said onto the paper that under PL 84 agreement we could not able to give food to India, so they cancelled it. First time we got irritated of USA. Second thing, we used to get import most of the milk powder from USA itself. When we are importing milk powder from USA and suddenly by the decade of 1970, they stated very clearly that we are not going to give you. So then the Prime Minister Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel requested the US government to set up a company in India and we'll give you each and everything free. But USA not have listened the words of Indian Prime Minister, and later we went on our own things itself, that we will able to learn in science and technology again after this international relations. Clear? So second issue is the milk powder. So two issues we got hurted, right? I'm just highlighting that thing also, you can have a look, right? So 480. So after these two issues, 1971 war issue, I think already explained in the before slide that Pakistan is very close to USA or USA is very close to Pakistan. In 1971, Mukti Bahan movement or Mukti Vahan movement, you can call it as, but in Bangladesh it has been called as Mukti Bahan movement, not Vahan, Mukti Bahan, Bahan movement. Clear? So Bangladesh was made a separate country in 1971 war. In that war, USA promised Pakistan that if India is hitting Pakistan, we will able to come and help you out. And strategically, we also took help from USSR. If USA is going to back up the Pakistan, USSR will be backup for India. So in that matter, the Prime Minister of USA, President of USA, had sent the 7th Fleet review to Indian Ocean. So in that issue also we got angry, right? I'm highlighting the third point, you can have a notes of it, right? So Pakistan and USA in defense matters, Pakistan and USA relations in all matters. Due to all these conditions, we got irritated with USA. You got my point, right? Now how we became? See, USA had some kind of a profit with India, but USA is angry on us. India had angry on USA, and India is getting some kind of profit from USA. But what made suddenly two enemies, how they became friends? Because the best friend Pakistan cheated with an agent called Osama bin Laden. He collapsed WTO. And always Pakistan is such a nasty country, I told you. They used to always give and give policy itself. You give me, I will take each and everything, but don't expect something from me. So no give and take policy. But in 11th 5-year plan, we stated very clearly that we wanted to increase our nuclear energy supply by 20,000 megawatt, which is a news buy came from 11th 5-year plan, which became a huge concern for the USA government. And I told you, they are a profit man minded. Whenever there is a profit, so Indian government at that time, we had just only 3,800 megawatt. Now we wanted to increase for 20,000 megawatt. So almost 16,000 megawatt we wanted to increase. When we wanted to increase 16,000 megawatt nuclear power in India, we required such a nuclear material also. That material will be supplied by USA. So that is the reason they had business and we want business. You understand that point, right? So in turn, we became friends. You understand my point? But before that point, we just wanted to understand how many presidents have came to India and whatever these presidents have made to India, what was the thing that they have given to India, or what India has given to them. You got to understand my point, right? So the first person is nothing but Dwight D. Eisenhower. You can able to, I just highlighted it, you can able to write. He was the 34th president. Right, he was the 34th president of USA. Before he became a president of USA, he was an army general in Europe. When USA has also been fighting in Europe area, Europe continent, he was an army person of USA army. That time he is also supporting NAM. He is also one of the founding member along with our Jawaharlal Nehru. But later when he became the president, he joined politics and he became a president of USA. So that time he was against of it. So USA under this president Dwight, USA always view India is just a buffer state against China. If we wanted to have a relationship with China, or if we wanted to have some kind of a fear or something like that, India can be used as a buffer state. That is what his idea is actually. You got to understand. So the first point that has to come into mind under whenever the term Dwight comes into picture, it is nothing but he has seen India as a buffer state. And the second person is Richard Nixon. Right? Second person is whom? Richard Nixon. I'm just highlighting it, that person also. You can able to find out. He is that person, Richard Nixon. I'm just highlighting his face also. The president that he's giving some kind of mal to this person, some flower garland. I just highlighted that person. He was 37th president of USA. Probably he was the third person in USA has resigned. And he was the vice president for earlier president. Eisenhower. He was the vice president for him. Nixon was very notorious. I told you already, in 1971 war, USA has sent the president of USA sent the 7th fleet in support to UK, support to Pakistan, I'm sorry. That person is nothing but the Nixon, right? The intelligence agencies have snatched the Nixon and his secretary about calling the Indian Prime Minister as this word. I can't spell it, but it is also important what these persons have did to us, right? And Nixon is the one, because you can able to find out the before Dwight wanted to have a relationship with China, but he could not able to do it. If he wanted to open a relationship with China, he wanted to use India as a buffer state. That is what he wanted to do it, but he could not able to do that, right? Nixon was credited globally opening a relationship with China. You got to understand, right? Next slide. Jimmy Carter, the third person who came to India, a third USA president who came to India is Jimmy Carter. Jimmy Carter is not like the other two presidents. They came only for one day visit to India. But this person is a democratic person. So he has got some kind of a warm welcome in India. He has been with 3 day visit. He came when the Manoj Desai is being the president, prime minister of India. So he was being bounded with so many moral values. But again, I told you that there is some kind of relationship in up and down with India. He caught up in a controversy in that time when Manoj Desai came into picture, the prime minister. That time India wanted to have the nuclear bomb, kind of material activity, nuclear ambitions. So he wanted to give some kind of a cold and blunt message. In that time, he is told to the media that I don't want to give any kind of message to India in terms of nuclear ambitions. But our again intelligence agencies have got some kind of a tape telling message related to that. Jimmy Carter wanted to give a cold and blunt message to India about the India's nuclear plan. But when this came into news and relayed it to the international media and to the India media, that time he left the country of India. So this is the kind of relationship that these three persons who came to India. You understand it, right? Right. The next one is the one Bill Clinton. So Bill Clinton visited India for the first time in 2000 during the Prime Minister of Atal Bihari Vajpayee. So he came for 5 day visit. He visited most of the institutions in India like IIMs and ISB and all. He is a very charming personality. He has got his daughter and he has roamed each and every place of beautiful places of India. And he called himself that I wanted to have a friendship with India. So due to that, from this point of time when Bill Clinton came to India, from that point of time onwards, the relationship between USA and India has started. And it took a separate step or separate shape from the point of George W. Bush. You got my point? So he is hugely unpopular in the world for the war on Iraq. That is father's idea or father's goal, whatever it may be. But a Hindustan Times survey stated that he was a very friend of their own country. And Indians also feel that he is a friend to India also. Right? George W. Bush and Manmohan Singh both have signed a civil nuclear agreement when the Bush came into India. From here onwards, our topic has to come into picture. Later, this has been revived and reassembled, or you can say much more agreements was being taken place after George W. Bush is with Barack Obama. He visited India in 6th and 9th. So he then the Prime Minister at that time, Manmohan Singh. So both had some kind of interest regarding with defense and other exports and IT and each and everything. Again, he has been looking forward to come in the 66th Republic Day chief guest also at that time. Later he came, we will also discuss those things. So almost all you can able to find out, before 2000, only three presidents who came to India, and those three presidents wanted to give some kind of a blunt message or some kind of a warning to Indian government. So due to those kind of stigma relation, Indian government and USA, the relation was not in a better shape. Always it should be in a better way itself. But when Clinton came into picture, from that day onward, the relation was turned into a good way, right? So what actually, why USA don't like us? You got my point. I already been communicated to you very clearly. They are a capitalist country, right? So capitalist country mean to say always a profit minded. See, this mighty nation India can't feed itself. When you are not feeding yourself, how you are going to give a profit to me? How you are going to do some kind of business with me? You got my point, right? You can't able to feed yourself. Why should I have to give some kind of business to you? Useless, right? So that is the reason the mighty nation can't able to feed themselves. So no use, no business. So that is the reason, first thing. Second thing, we said very clearly NAM. NAM mean to say non-aligned movement. And we have not communicated properly to the global community that NAM doesn't mean to say neutral. most of the Western powers or most of the European continent understood NAM mean to say neutral. If they said it is a neutral, then why India has been close to USA? It is a stigma that has been attached to US. You got my point. When in a relationship, if two persons are in a huge misconception, that is their problem, the two persons have to sit and solve it. The same way, if a person is not understanding yourself, if the person is not, can't be understood by any other person, now it is your responsibility to make yourself say what you are exactly wanted to say. Now the same issue with the Indian government also. Western and European continent entirely, or the, you can say the Western countries entirely, the thought NAM mean to say neutral. If it is a neutral, then why India became very close to USSR? You got my point? Right. And USA wanted to have dominance on the Asian country, Asian continent also. So for that they used Pakistan and Afghanistan before. It couldn't happen. And they wanted to be use India also, but India won't give a choice for them. So in third point also, it's not happening. When under these three conditions, if you are not helping the USA government, then obviously what is the use? They are capitalists, they'll always go for the profit minded. And the second thing, dominance of state. India is not a liberalized country. Everything, if any company wanted to set up in India, you need to take permission from the Indian government itself. And they will give you permissions after 6 months or 1 year, and neither you not able to get any kind of permission also. And for a capitalist country, it is not good for them. So due to these reasons, USA don't like us. As mean to say India, not US. Clear? Next. But how the seed of friendship started between both the countries? Now I told you, Indian government don't like USA, USA government don't like India. But one party needs business and one party, India need business, India had money. USA had nuclear fuel, USA wanted to sell it. There is a demand and supply. So demand and supply equation can be solved simply. So you can able to understand the seed of friendship, how it comes into work. India started from 1991 saying that LPG, liberalization, privatization, globalization scheme. So we liberalized each and everything. If you can go through the policy of 1991, you can able to understand. NAM closed practically because from 1991, the USSR was got dissolved. So this I already communicated. So business start. So the story starts from here. How the story starts? From here you will able to understand the Indo-US relationship. 50 years India, Indians and India were free. Only three presidents visited. Entire period was misconception. The entire misconception air was cleared by the Bill Clinton visit for 5 days trip. You understand? Right? Before this business, we should have to talk some important issues. I'll explain all these things. So now when we both are getting closure, we have to tell that how India supported them, and USA also have to say that how both supported. Suppose let's say if X and Y are two different entities and they don't like each other, but due to some kind of profit thought made both to come into the same platform, then they have to say that you are better in this, so that is the reason I'm getting friendship with you. And the same way the Y also says this, you are better in this, Baba, so that is the reason I wanted to get friendship with you. You got to understand, right? So these two things made to come into picture. Now the gravity of terror was understood in 5 days when Bill Clinton came into picture, and Islamistic fundamentalists, 9/11 attacks, WTO, all these things was happened in the period of 2000 to 2004, 2005 in the period itself. Now obviously what it turned to be. Now both the countries, India is also facing the same kind of problem from Pakistan and from Bangladesh also. So India opened counter-terrorism, and USA also have facing the same kind of problem. This trouble of terrorism made the both the countries to come into close. You got to understand. So that is the reason a bilateral link was developed between the both the countries. And in this bilateral link, what they wanted to talk? They wanted to talk how to counter the terrorism. So for that, they have started a joint commission for counter-terrorism. Understood? This is important for MCQ, please note it down. First kind of a treaty or first kind of organization that started between the two countries is nothing but the Joint Commission of Counterterrorism, right? The next one. Gradually, the counterterrorism was improved because our relation is getting better. So now, when it's getting better, now India and USA signed in defense cooperation also and high technology cooperation also. Right, for this defense technology, now see, first of all, we have discussed only terrorism. We started, our both the countries came on a single platform to talk about terrorism. Now, terrorism, you required the forces to come out of the picture. Forces required defense cooperation. So now defense cooperation. Defense required high technology equipment and high technology weapon, each and everything. So all these things made to form another group, which is nothing but high technology cooperation group. I'll just highlight it. What is it? So second organization between Indian government and USA. The first one is joint. It is also important for MCQ, please. I'm just underlining it. I'm just highlighting it with a different color. You can able to find out, right? In January 2004, India and USA expanded their cooperation in three specific areas other than the above three. Understood? Those are called civilian nuclear activities, civilian space programs, and high-tech trade. You can able to find out. I am tick marking over here. So all these three you call it as a trinity. Please make a point, it is called a trinity. It is very important for MCQ. It is a third organization which came in between of Indian government and USA. Understood? Now later, finally, defense was also added into that. You can able to find out civil nuclear activity, civilian space program, high-tech trade, high technology trade. All these three things you call it as a trinity. And for that, defense was also added. When defense added, it is a fourth one, right? It is called quaternity. In the same year, September 2004, USA announced a next step in strategic partnership, which is called NSSP. Very important for your MCQ again. What is this NSSP talks about? NSSP, object and use of NSSP. I'm just highlight once again, very important for your MCQ part. And this does not get any kind of weightage because there's already been a part of a question in civils 2013 mains. So this topic is no use of anything. This topic is only used for your MCQ as of now, nothing much. It is not required. It does not get any kind of weightage, right? It don't have any water as of now. Clear? Right. The biggest outcome of establishing the NSSP initiative was to enable the USA to make modification to export licensing policy that would foster cooperation in commercial and space program and permit certain exports to power plant and safeguard nuclear facilities. It's as simple as that. USA won't give their nuclear technology or any other kind of technology to any other countries. USA will give their technology to only some particular group of countries. USA, without hesitating anything, they can able to give the technology to only one country in the world, that is UK. And other than UK, they will give their technology with some kind of conditions to 8 countries. India was one of them in 8. It became a part through NSSP. You understand the point, right? Right. So now, after you can able to find out, first they have been when Clinton came into picture, they started on terrorism, they started defense, they started high technology trade, or then they have started their own what do you call the nuclear technology, civil nuclear program, and each and everything, which you call it as a trinity. And then defense was added to the trinity, it is called quaternity. And high technology group was been a second group which came into picture between the India and US relationship. That is what we have done so far, right? So when 2015, I already been communicated that Obama became the chief of Republic Day, right? He was the chief guest of the Republic Day. When he came into picture, which you call it as a January nuclear breakthrough, which the media used to call. It is not between, you can't call it as the Indian government signed or the USA government have signed nuclear breakthrough. It is the media in Indian government and the world government, in the international media, has called it as a nuclear breakthrough. Understood? In 2005, India and USA have signed nuclear non-proliferation regime. USA said very clearly that we will provide from now onwards nuclear reactor building and technology also, but on some conditions. before that, before if we wanted to give our technology and other thing to you, you have to separate the civilian, whatever the nuclear energy thermal reactors in India, that you need to separate. You make them separate into civilian and military purpose. You tell me how many nuclear reactors you had in India and make them separate. How many that you wanted to use for military purpose and how many you wanted to use for civilian purpose for producing electricity. So that we call it as a separation plan 2006. Again, very, very important to you. Please make a point. Separation plan is also called as important for MCQ. Clear? The conditions are, if USA wanted to give their technology, you can able to find out, USA wanted to give their nuclear reactor building and technology on some conditions. What are the conditions? First one, you need to separate a plan. Second thing, India will have assume non-proliferation responsibilities, right? India will protect the fissile material and nuclear technology also. If you could able to do all these things, then only we will able to give you, right? So whenever India's USA government said, if we are going to give technology and nuclear material, but before that you need to separate your civilian and military purpose, you have to show me. So that time Indian government separated their plan. Separation plan was initiated by the Indian government by March 2006. It's finalized and India committed itself. And under this plan, 14 out of 22 power reactors was placed under IAEA safeguards. That means to say, out of 22, 14 we are going to use for civilian purposes and rest of all we are using for military purposes. You understand the point, right? The next one. So now what is this Indo-US nuclear deal is all about? Right?